The New York Times Travel Show, January 27th through 29th at the Jacob Javits Center in New York City. It's the whole world under one roof.
Hi, I'm Ernie Shemizi, and welcome to WVVH-TV's coverage of the New York Times Travel Show.
I want to take a moment to extend thanks on behalf of the New York Times to our sponsors and supporters of the New York Times Travel Show. Now, in its 14th year, the New York Times Travel Show is the largest consumer and trade event in North America. Our show hosts nearly 30,000 industry professionals, consumers, and features more than 500 sponsors and exhibitors representing over 150 countries. I want to extend special thanks to our gold sponsor, South Africa Tourism, which has supported the travel show for 10 years. Please join me in welcoming Bangu Masisi, the U.S. Manager of South African Tourism, to say a few words.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you very much for joining us this afternoon. Today, we mark the official opening of the 14th anniversary of the New York Times show. And as South African Tourism, we're very excited to be celebrating our 10th year as a sponsor for the, you know, for the show.
Laura, what an exciting day. This is Laura Sonnenfeld, who is with the New York Times.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, it's extremely exciting. This is the 14th annual show for the New York Times Travel Show. And this is our trade day. And we are going to have about 9,000 people coming through today on trade. And then tomorrow, about 20,000 people. And again on Sunday, so which is our consumer days. And we're looking forward to a great weekend.
Well, if this is any indication, this is opening day. You just cut the ribbon.
Yep.
And this event has become the largest of its kind.
Yes, it has. It is the largest trade and consumer travel show in North America. Yep. And we have over 500 exhibitors here. 150 countries are represented with lots of great things to do.
Now, Laura, you have the travel professional who's part of this, but it's also open to our New York public.
Yes. So we have two consumer days, Saturday and Sunday, and that is when the public can come. And today is the trade day.
Yep. So for the public that will be coming, they can experience countries from all over the world.
There's so many countries. There's so many, if you know, I'm sure you will walk the show, but there's various pavilions where all of the countries are represented. But beyond that, there's also a wellness pavilion, and there's a kids stage. There's lots of different food to taste. There's things for kids to do.
And seminars.
And there's lots of seminars, absolutely, on, you know, travel tips, what to do if there's some kind of issue while you're traveling, what's the best way to use your travel points.
Well, knowing that the New York Times is behind us, you know that it's second to none, and this travel is important to the New York Times.
It is. It is one of our biggest categories, and it is one of our signature editorial pieces, because people come to us because they know that we're going to be providing them with interesting information and places to go. Every year we have something called 52 Places to Go, which covers the places that our editors have determined are the places to go in 2017.
We invite our viewers this weekend here at the Javits Center, New York Times Travel Show. Laura, for our viewers that are interested in more information, you have a great website.
We do. It's nytravelshow.com.
So all the information is there.
Yep.
You'll experience the world and some good deals too, you know.
Yes, absolutely.
We're New Yorkers, we like a bargain.
Yes.
And
yes.
Continue.
You can book your trips, you can plan just gather information. There's all sorts of things.
And learn about destinations you never even knew existed.
Absolutely.
Well, continued success, Laura, to you and your fine team at the New York Times. And thank you for inviting us. We're proud to be one of your media sponsors. celebrating 10 years as a sponsor here at the New York Times Travel Show. This is Bangu, and Bangu represents South Africa.
We're very excited because this is our 10th year as being a sponsor for the travel show. And our partnership with New York Times Travel Show has really given us the opportunity to be able to access all the people who sell South Africa as well as the consumer over the weekend. So we're looking forward to that.
South Africa is such a beautiful country. And as people discover South Africa, you have to go back again and again to enjoy all that your country has to offer.
Yeah, contrary to what sometimes people think, that South Africa is a once-in-a-lifetime destination, but once people have been, they realize that there's so much more to do. And particularly this year, from last year to this year, we're promoting, like, South Africa's got variety. There's, like, Safari Plus. It's not only about safari that we are known of. And as it is, we're launching our new campaign, Wow South Africa, to the consumer and to trade, for us for them to realize that the variety of all exciting and riveting experiences that South Africa has to offer.
Now, this is the New York Times Travel Show, so you have those hardened professional travelers, plus it's open to the public, and everyone stops by here and takes a look at what South Africa has to offer. So what would be your dream vacation for that first-time visitor to South Africa?
I would still say, because we are known for safari, you have to include safari in that. But then Cape Town is well known as well. It's a beautiful city, but we are trying to introduce other cities as well for people to realize that the diversity of South Africa. Most people fly into Johannesburg, and then we urge them to spend 2 to 3 days before they go to Cape Town. And then you can have a road trip as well from Cape Town to the Eastern Cape, where you could end up having a safari there.
Well, thank you. You're representing a beautiful country, and thank you for being part of this New York Times Travel Show. This is a big one, isn't it?
It is. It's one of the biggest in North America. We're very excited to be part of it.
Great partnership, South Africa and New York Times.
Yes, great partnership.
New York Times Travel Show has so much to offer, and I tell you are a find. Of all the people that I've interviewed, I've never met the New York Sherpa.
There you go.
And this is Josiah Brown. And Josiah, you know everything there is to know about New York, traveling this great state and enjoying it.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I've traveled over 500,000 miles across the state, and there's so much to do in New York. I think one of the most misconceived things about our state is that New York has absolutely international level destinations. We have the Culinary Institute of America. We have Franklin Roosevelt's Presidential Library and Museum, which was the first Presidential Library and Museum. We have the oldest sports venue in the nation at Saratoga Racetrack, and on and on and on until you get to Niagara Falls, which, of course, is a wonder of the world. So what we're here to do today is to try to say, you're in the most amazing city in the world, jump on a train, get in a car, get on a plane, and go experience wine country or the breweries and some of the culture across New York, and spend a week or spend a weekend, because it not only enriches you, but it helps the state and it helps all the people who are a part of the New York State tourism industry.
So. And it's so different, because you can travel within this state and experience different climates. If you live in Buffalo,
that's true.
You know, it's like unbelievable and all that they have to offer. Our TV station is based in the Hamptons, so you know what that part
of,
when you mentioned wine country and whatever.
Absolutely.
But you've seen the real beauty that this state has to offer.
Yes.
What comes to mind when you think of, wow, the equivalent of our Grand Canyon that takes your breath away?
Well, we have, I would say, probably three different things I would mention. First of all, the Adirondack Park is the largest park in the continental United States. You could fit Grand Canyon, Yosemite, Yellowstone, and Acadia inside of Adirondack Park. And it's an experiment that had never happened before, because they took 6 million acres and preserved it, and 3 million are forever wild and 3 million are private. So you can go stay at a resort, take your kids to an amazing water park, and the next day be in the absolute wilderness. And so if you start your journey in Lake George or Lake Placid or Old Forge on the western side of the park, there is just stunning, stunning beauty up there. As you move a little west, you hit the Finger Lakes region, which is the New York's largest wine region, 208 wineries. And you're just going to go through rolling hills of lakes and wine and vineyards. And then, obviously, you can stand 3 feet from the edge of Niagara Falls, and it just rumbles under your feet. The mist hits your face. These are, you know, international-level experiences that are within 3 to 4 or 5 hours away from right here in New York City.
Well, you love New York. The New York Sherpa. Do you have a website?
Yes, or what, New York's Best connect? Experience. NewYorksBestExperiences.com, and we have a little bit of a sampling there. And people can also go to IsleOfNewYork.com to see even more of the story. So
super cool, Josiah. Cool.
Thanks for giving us the
Come
time.
Come to Brooklyn too. You
yeah,
know,
we love Brooklyn.
We're making so many new friends here at the New York Times Travel Show. And this is Marie-Ève Perron.
Bonjour.
Yeah, bonjour. And you're from?
Quebec City.
Quebec City, yeah. All the way to New York City.
Yeah, it's an hour, very close, an hour and a half by plane.
Oh, a world away, I tell you. It's such a and you have something very special to share with our viewers.
Yes. I represent Le Monastère des Augustines. We are a new wellness hotel, a new but also a 400 years old wellness hotel located in an old monastery that used to be the first hospital actually in North America and Canada and the US. So it was lately converted into a wellness hotel to perpetuate its mission of healing.
And how many rooms? What are
We do have 65 rooms on site. Some are located in the authentic cloister from the 17th century. So it's really to sleep in the old sister's cell. We also have a wellness center on site, a museum, all kind of programs in holistic health and culture, an archive center, a restaurant of healthy food, and more.
So how would it work? If someone comes, do they spend a weekend, a few days? What is the typical visitor?
Yes, there are many packages offered. Some visitors come on a cultural perspective and will go with the room and breakfast. Some will go further in the wellness journey and take the full board and all the programs. So every day we have meditation, yoga, all kind of activities. So depending on the interest and the profile of the visitor, many possibilities are offered.
Now, what a creative use of a healing spiritual facility.
It is, definitely. And the most beautiful part of it is we are a nonprofit, and all the profits that are generated by our activities are reinvested in our social mission. So at Le Monastère, we welcome, for example, family caregiver, professional of our healthcare system to help them inspire from the work of the sister. So we really give back to the society.
Well, it would be a retreat with unbelievable benefits. Do you have a website?
Yes, it's Monastère, like monastery, but with an E at the end, .ca.
The beautiful country of Mexico is very well represented here at the New York Times Travel Show, and I'm with Daniela Lehman.
That's right.
And Daniela, what a wonderful country you have.
Thank
Please
you.
Tell us about this New York Times Travel Show and Mexico.
The New York Times Travel Show is very important for us. We do it every year. We've been doing it for many, many years, and we're very excited to have grown our exhibitors here with us. We have all kinds of destinations and hoteliers. So welcome. Come to Mexico. Bienvenidos.
Oh, bienvenidos. So you have all different areas represented.
Yes.
So just for our viewers who might come to the New York Times Travel Show, what can they find here?
They can find beautiful Yucatan, Los Cabos, Puerto Vallarta. We have some exhibitors from Cancun. So yeah, that's an overview. We have Xcaret and Tianguis Turístico, which is one of our biggest tourism marketplace events in Mexico. So we have all kinds of information for people to come and join us.
Mexico has a lot to offer.
Yes.
And what's really big these days, number one, you have a lot of cruise lines that come to Mexico, and it's part of the destination.
That's right.
And you have the cruise industry also represented here, don't you?
The cruise industry. Well, we have Yucatan, which is a cruise on a stop on the routes that the cruises take from the East Coast. That's one of the biggest ones.
Right, absolutely. And also, what's really big these days are these all-inclusive resort areas.
Oh, yes. Cancun.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Cancun is one of the biggest ones, and Los Cabos is starting to have this thematic of all-inclusives also.
Well, we thank you for being part of the New York Times Travel Show. You'll be here through Sunday.
Through Sunday.
You've got a great website also that helps promote.
Yes, visitmexico.com.
Couldn't be any easier. Visitmexico.com. Here at the New York Times Travel Show, this is Denise Reichwein-Lees. There's a party behind you here.
Yeah, I know. It's great to be here.
This is some event, and you're representing one of our great sponsors here, MSC.
Yes, we're delighted to be here again. This is actually our second year as a sponsor. If you were here last year, you obviously see a big change in what we've done. So we're delighted to be back. And we really have a lot of exciting news to share about all of our growth here in the North American market.
Okay, now, you got to let our viewers know, what does MSC do so very well?
Well, you know, we bring to the marketplace a very unique opportunity, a very different choice in cruising. Many times people might say, well, you're different, and why is that good? We like to think that we embrace these differences, everything from the authenticity of the products we use on board to our award-winning entertainment and our revolutionary ships that we build.
So are you booking, if one of our viewers wants to book travel on MSC, are we in a position here to give them all the information they need?
Oh, absolutely. Please reach out to us. We obviously work through a large network of travel partners, and we have a huge staff here today to help you, and we have some great offers going on as well at the show. So definitely reach out, come by and see us. Booth 621, we're here all weekend.
Okay, they're making deals here at MSC, and thank you for being part of the New York Times Travel Show.
Thanks for having us.
Where's our music?
No, they finished.
Great seeing you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Perfect. Desde el Nabo la tomé, no dicen que nací en el roble. Dicen que soy arriero, que le chico y se paran. Y les sabiendo el sombrero, ya verán cómo reparan. Ay, ay, ay. Borracho vengo, que me siga la tambora, que me toque en el que libre, que es el niño perdido, por último el torito, a que veas como le pinto, ay, 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 mamá por enamorado, pero de eso nada tengo. Me dicen el negro, pero con suerte, que si me falta un gallo no me le arranco a la muerte. Ay, 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 mamá por Dios. Con las que borracho vengo, que me siga la tambora, que me toque en el que dice, que ese niño perdido, contigo el torito, a que veas como me limpo. Ay, ay, ay.
It's our opening day here at the New York Times Travel Show, and we are so thrilled to be joined by Costa Rica. You are Costa Rica. This is Inez and Alejandro, and welcome to this great show and the New York Times. What a premier show this is, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Very happy to be here in this great location to promote our country, Costa Rica.
What a beautiful country. Inez, this show is selling Costa Rica and what you marketing, what Costa Rica has to offer, that's a nice thing to do.
Absolutely. We find that it's important to have a presence here within the community, as the travel community amongst consumers as well as media. For us, the message of who we are, it's something that we want to continue running through years to come. For us, we pride on, as a country, as a whole, and understand that the importance today for travelers, consumers alike, are looking for unique experiences, and that's what Costa Rica has to offer. It is a country that can offer, you tell me what time of year you want to go, and I'll tell you what you could do there. So it is a year-round destination, and for that person seeking an authentic experience, that's who we are.
Now, Alejandro, you know your country. For that first-time viewer who wants to come to visit Costa Rica, where should they go?
Yeah, Costa Rica is a destination that has a touristic product all over the country. So you could merge a lot of different experiences together in the same trip. For example, you could go to volcanoes, visit their hot springs, relax at the beach, go to one of our rainforests and see all the lush vegetation. So I would recommend them to combine all sorts of experiences in one trip.
And so much of the country is protected.
Yes.
It really will never be developed. So the beauty you experience today, you'll experience
for years to come.
That's
exactly
right.
Is there a website?
Yes, there is. Visit CostaRica.com. You can find more information regarding the country, regions, and just specifics as it relates to the country.
We invite our viewers to come to the New York Times Travel Show. You can't miss Costa Rica, because as you walk in, you guys are in the number one position here, and continued success. Now, who wouldn't want to go to Antigua and Barbuda? And I'm with Dean Fenton, who knows all about both of those places.
Very much so. Antigua and Barbuda is a beautiful destination. We have 365 wonderful beaches. One beach every day of the year.
Wow.
Yes.
That's why you're such a happy man.
I love it. Sunshine all year round, beaches all year round to go to, and the beach is just the beginning, because there's so much other things to do.
So tell us, I mean, tourism is so important to your country and what you're presenting here. But you offer a lot, don't you?
We do. We have a great cross-section of properties to choose from when you get to the island. Great culinary experience if you need that as well. We have one of the largest sailing regatta in the Caribbean. We also have one of the best carnival around, 60 years and running. So there's lots and lots of things, fun things to do in Antigua.
Now, this New York Times Travel Show, you know, this is the big league here.
Absolutely. It's the biggest show in our backyard. You're talking about 29,000 people that's going to be here over the weekend. So we want to get some of that action and send some of those guys down to our wonderful destination.
Well, we're going to tell our viewers, come down, see Dean. And not only in seeing Dean, but you have a great website also.
Yes, it's www.visitantiguabarbuda.com.
I don't know if I could do 365, but one good, beautiful beach in the middle of this winter makes anybody happy.
Absolutely. Come on down and see us. We got daily flights out of JFK on American, United as well. Come on down, have a grand time in Antigua and Barbuda.
It's like we're in Aruba.
We are, pretty much.
To our viewers, this is Natasha Felix in Aruba. What an island.
I know, right? I mean, I'm biased because I am Aruban, so I love it. So it's what we call it, our one happy island, because everybody's pretty much very happy there. And I can say bon vini, welcome to New York Times Travel Show.
Yes, and what a beautiful island, and you offer so much.
We do. We are an island that has over 90 nationalities, and so what that brings with it is on culinary, we have such a wide variety of cuisines that kind of blended and brought in that Caribbean Aruban thing in there. So even though you have different cuisines, it still has a personal Aruban touch to it. And we have great restaurants with, which makes Aruba so fantastic, is that you have restaurants where you're actually dining with your toes in the water or in the sand. And so that's an experience that, as beautiful as New York is, you're not going to get that here. And but we have activities. And Aruba, as small as it is, it has a very interesting topography, because on one side you have the white sandy beaches and the palm trees, and on the other side it's like that. It's all very arid and dry and cactus, and so it's an interesting little island for us, as small as it is.
So much to offer.
Yes.
It's the winter. To my fellow New Yorkers, leave.
Come to Aruba!
Your website?
Easy. Aruba.com. ARUBA.com.
One of the great benefits of this New York Times travel show is that we meet people like Sunil Kumar Lal Gund, who is one of the, he's the assistant director, sir, right, of India Tourism. And welcome to the New York Times Travel Show.
Thank you, thank you.
Are you prepared for 30,000 people coming to see and learn about India travel?
I'm basically tourism board, and we give a platform for our tour operators, Indian tour operators, to come and just participate here and promote India in different ways. Yeah.
Now, what a beautiful country you represent, and what a wonderful people.
Yes, yes.
And it's a democracy, and it has all the things that that one would want in travel.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
and history, sir.
It's incredible, basically. One word is sufficient, I think, incredible India. It's incredible.
Yes, exactly. So, and I want to add the food also is magnificent.
Yeah, food is also magnificent, and it's very exciting. The cuisine, Indian cuisine, and a lot of exciting things. Yeah.
Now, do you have a website for our
viewers? Yeah, we have a website. This is our website, www.incredibleindia.org. And anything, every information is there.
Excellent. Well, we welcome our viewers to come and see Sunil and learn more about India and all that your beautiful country has to offer. Thanks for being part of the show. Daytona.
Yes.
Oh, what a place, huh?
Yes, love it. I wish I was there today. It's a lot warmer.
Well, you're here today, here in New York, at the Javits Center, representing Daytona Beach and Visit Florida.
Yes. 23 miles of beach. The sand is very hard packed at low tide, so you could actually drive a car on the beach if you'd like to, or ride a bicycle on the beach. But we actually also have a section of beach with no cars at all. So if you have little ones, or if you're concerned about that, we have that for you too.
What a friendly town you have.
Very much so. We have a whole bunch of brand new hotels that have opened up, a brand new Residence Inn on the beach, a brand new Hilton Garden Inn on the beach. We actually have the world's first Hyatt place on the beach. I have a 5-star Westin hotel that's opening in August, and the International Speedway has just completed their $400 million expansion, and they're also building an entertainment complex directly across the street from the Speedway.
I know, like you said, you'd rather be in Daytona today instead of being in the middle of New York City, but you are educating all of us to come to Daytona.
And we're also bragging about our nonstop air service from JetBlue, from JFK.
Oh, wow.
And we're thinking they're going to be adding a second flight, so it'll be twice a day.
Wow.
Yes.
All right. So come and see Roxanne. This is the place.
Yes.
Daytona Beach.
Booth 857.
Okay. Very good. Here at the New York Times Travel Show. And what's your website for Daytona?
DaytonaBeach.com.
All right. Sounds cool. The New York Times Travel Show will be here through Sunday. For WVVH-TV, I'm Ernie Shimizi.
The New York Times Travel Show, January 27th through 29th at the Jacob Javits Center in New York City. It's the whole world under one roof.